Hey, what's going on, guys? I'm Mike for Halo Follower. In Halo, one of the most iconic Covenant weapons is the Needler. Named based on the razor-sharp crystals the weapon fires, its actual name is the Type 33 Guided Munitions Launcher. According to sources, the crystalline projectiles are believed to use heat or organic signatures to hone in on targets, though they do not attract to friendlies. But what if the Needler was real? The Needler's range varies game to game, but the average velocity is quite slow at only about 8 meters per second. That means that, if shot from the Master Chief at ground level, it should have a maximum range of about 5.3 meters. In the game, though, the range is much farther, with significantly less drop-off. The weapon has two major means of damage, the impact and the super combine. On the Needler, most of the damage is due to the super combine because of the velocity. If the projectile was traveling at a lot faster rate, the impact energy and therefore damage would be devastating. The question is, why does the Needler fire so slowly? The answer may lie with the heat-seeking portion of the weapon. The range is significantly farther than what it should be from the initial velocity and equations of motion. It's likely that the needle transforms from a solid to a gas from the inside out, almost acting as a propellant for the needle through the air. If the material properties of the crystal was attracted to organic material, then this may be how the needle has the lock-on mechanic. It seems as if the trade-off is between increased velocity and increased lock-on potential. With an increase in needle velocity, such as the needle rifle, the weapon loses nearly all of its lock-on functionality, but gains in more precise projectiles that can pierce armor and are harder to outmaneuver. With the Needler, we see an easier learning curve that doesn't require precise fire from the operator. The rounds are less reliable against armor and are easier to outmaneuver, but an army of cheap, untrained soldiers outfitted with the Needler can be quite devastating. The super combine aspect of the Needler is far-fetched in a lot of aspects, but more believable in others. For starters, there are elements that violently react with water. Potassium, sodium, really anything in that column of the periodic table could be used. It's possible that a chain reaction could take place, whereas the more links in the chain, the more violent. It's also possible that each needle is laced with maybe a minor amount of explosives. This can explain why when the needle is fired into the open air, the range is significantly limited just by a minor explosion destroying the needle. Maybe the whole thing is on a timer. Unless the concentration reaches a certain point, the needle explodes. Needle ammunition is also not as damaging to soft targets due to lower kinetic energy and smaller impact area. Traditional ammunition is used to maximize accuracy and damage. Needle ammunition simply isn't as good at either. In the game, the needles are more like crystals, which may or may not make them more devastating. If anything, the Needler would be a terror weapon intended to scare people, not as a really high damage, high efficiency weapon. There are many unanswered questions about how the Needler actually operates, but we'll have to give the Covenant the benefit of the doubt and just say they probably figured it out. But that's all the time I have for today. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to give it a like and check out the other videos on this channel. And anyways, guys, thanks for watching.